All right, so last video, what we have seen is how to write batch class. What is batch class? This video, we are going to execute the batch class and I'm going to show you how it works. Okay, so the scenario is very simple. I'm assuming that I have 100,000 leads where name is equal to Alex. I have 200,000 leads where name is equal to Alex. I have 300,000. I have only one data, by the way. I have so only one record I have created named Alex. But you, for an example, you think that there are more than 50,000 leads with name Alex. Now my code, what it is doing, if you see, it is fetching the data where name is equal to Alex. In execute method, what it is doing is checking if the lead's email is blank, which in this case it is blank. Let me show you this. See, the email is blank. So it is checking if the lead email is blank, then it is just updating the email as alex@xyz.com. Very simple. So I have only one record, but this code will work when you have more than 50,000 record with name Alex. Correct? Okay, so now let's understand how to call a batch class. See, the way you call a normal Apex class, class name dot method name, that's not going to work out. So the way we call a batch class is, let me go to the anonymous window, copy the class name, obj is equal to new class name. Okay, so you first have to instantiate that batch class with the help of this line, right? This is the reference variable. And then there's a class called database dot, there's a method called execute batch. See how simple it is, right? So there's a class called database, there's a method called execute batch. All you need to do is you have to pass this particular reference variable inside it. That's it, your job is done. This is how you call a batch class. The way you call a normal Apex class, class name dot method name, or you instantiate and then you call like obj dot method name. But the way you call batch class is like this, because batch class has these three methods, no? So remember I told you that batch, you can specify the batch size, could be 200 to 2000. So the batch size, if you want to specify, you have to give here comma 2000. So by default, if you don't give any batch size, it takes like 200. And if, let's assume that if you have like, you know, 200,000 records, and if you give no batch size, it takes by default 200. It takes a decade to complete. By the way, it takes like a couple of hours to complete. So better to specify the batch size, you know, based on the volume of data that you have to process. Okay. Now, once you're done with this two line in your anonymous window, now you can call the batch class from any other Apex class or any other. We're going to learn something called asynchronous method after this video, right? So you can call your batch class from another a class, or maybe from trigger or whatever. Correct. So this is how you're going to call the batch class. And once you execute this, let me show you how you as an admin or developer can keep a track on that batch class. By the way, if my code is correct, no, if I refresh, see, there'll be an email called alex@xyz.com. I hope my code works. So here we go. alex@xyz.com. So if you have 100,000 record with name Alex, every single record will be updated with an email called alex@xyz.com. That's the magic of batch class, nothing. Okay, now let's see how you as an admin or developer can keep a track, right, on the batch class, right? So there is something called Apex job. If you go and search in the setup, what is that? Apex job, right? So if you go to your Apex job, you will get to see the batch which is on queue, which has already been executed, how many batch sizes are there, every single details you can check from this Apex job. Okay, let this get open. So the one that I just executed, you know, this is the one, total batch size one. Why? Because the batch size I have given, if you remember, 2000. So if there are, suppose, 6000 record that is fetching, that this SQL query is fetching, then what should be the batch size? So if you have 6000 record that your SQL query is trying to fetch, what should be your total batch sizes? 6000 divided by 2000. So three batch size, right? So so it shows you what's the submitted date, what's the job type. It's a batch Apex. Sometime we're going to learn schedule Apex, which will come here in the same page also, right? The batch status, whether it's completed, failed. If you got failed, by the way, sometimes the batch doesn't run, right? Let's say you have some validation rule and that is actually stopping the batch to run. You get a detailed error message over here in the status. Okay, and how many batches got processed, how many batches got failed, all the details you get from here. So if the batch is taking some time, I mean, you know, when it comes to a bigger volume of data, sometimes it takes a couple of minutes. So if you want to check how many batch has been processed, I mean, has failed, all the details, what the error message, you have to come here in the Apex job and check this out. Okay. So this is how you have to write a batch, execute the batch, and track the batch job over here. Again, I'm just showing you how to write a batch and all, right? You can call the batch Apex from a trigger, from even from flow also you can call the batch class nowadays, right? So that's all about batch class. Next video I'm going to talk about something called schedule class. But before you go into the schedule class, my recommendation is I'm going to give you this piece of code. Okay. It's a very simple code. Okay. Not much complex. All you need to do is watch out this video, understand each and every word I'm saying, understand the concept, and try to copy and paste the same code in your org. Do some little bit of tweak and execute the batch and see how it's working. All right. You have to get the feel, right? How, the way you can get the feel is you have to implement the same thing in your developer org. That's when you get some in-depth details about it. Right. So that's it for this video. Next video, let's talk about schedule Apex. See you in the next video.